हाय व्यूअर्स एंड ऑडियंस, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कवर द टॉपिक्स यू आर वॉचिंग इन दिस स्क्रीन. द टाइटल, सम बेसिक टर्मिनोलॉजीज ऑफ वाटर कोर्सेज. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट आवर टू डेज टॉपिक. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द टर्मिनोलॉजीज. वाटर कोर्स, दैट इज द चैनल विच कन्वेज वाटर फ्रॉम द माइनर टू द फार्मर्स फील्ड एंड यूज फॉर द इरीगेशन purposes. Next, the terminology is the discharge. Volume of water flow per unit time is also known as the flow rate, denoted by Q. And its formula is the Q is equal to A into V. If we know the cross-sectional area and the velocity by the water is flowing in the channel, multiply by them, we can get the value of the discharge area. It is the cross-sectional area of the channel where the water flows, denoted by A. Wetted parameter, it is the length of the parameter of the area of flowing water in contact with the water channel and denoted by the P, hydraulic radius. Ratio of the flow to wetted parameter is expressed the shape of the channel. While calculating all these, please consider the units must be in the same system. By this picture, we will discuss the above parameters. This is the cross-sectional area, the blue color. It is the area and the velocity. From this cross-sectional, in unit time, you can take the units feet per second, meter per second. In 1 second, how much this water is traveling from that point. So we can multiply this by the area. We will get the discharge. And the hydraulic radius, second is the wetted parameter. You see this point, and through along the surface of the water channel up to this point, this length is the wetted parameter. That is the main purpose of in earthen channel, to reduce the wetted parameter to minimize the water contact with the water channel surface, to minimize the water losses. And hydraulic radius, again, that is the ratio of A over P. Now, there is some specific information of the water channel on the basis of their cross-sectional. Rectangular shape cross-section, see, Y into B plus Y cot alpha. If you have the angle of the slope of the side, we can use this formula. And if you have the slope in terms of Z, you can use this formula for this purpose. Similarly, the rectangular wetted parameter for the above shape parameters, and this is the wetted parameter formula for this second, which is giving the legends in terms of Z and the Y. Rectangular hydraulic radius, it is the A over P. The next one, this is the triangular cross section. This is the shape of the area, and this one is the wetted parameter, triangular shape, hydraulic radius. Next one is the rectangular water channel, depth into width, and wetted parameter is this side is B, and this the depth, and B is the bottom width. So 2y, this y and this y, plus the width of this channel is the wetted parameter. By using this concept in other shapes, we can also calculate this wetted parameter easily. And hydraulic radius of this shape is the A over P, BY divided by B plus 2B. This one is the most efficient cross sectional for the water courses. This is the circular shape, which is not in practice these days due to some reasons we will discuss in some individual lecture. And these are the parameters of this. These days, in practice, this is the cross section, that is the parabolic cross section. For the area of the parabolic cross section is the 2/3 x, this is a multiply by t into d. T is the top width of the channel and d is the depth. and what weighted parameter you can calculate by using this formula. Y and D is the similar. D is also the depth of the water, and it's noted in the picture is the noted by Y. And the parabolic shape hydraulic cross section. See velocity. During the water channel design, we calculate the velocity. To optimize the velocity, we will consider this formula. This is the Manning's formula. Here is the component of this formula is the V is the velocity, N is the roughness coefficient, Manning's coefficient. It depends upon the surface. If there is iron, concrete, cement or brick lining, the values will be different and you can find in the literature. R is the hydraulic radius and S is the slope. During the process of the channel design, we use this formula to select the velocity. And other thing, we have the nomograph to determine the velocity. See, there is procedure how to select the velocity from this. There are five lines. On the leftmost side, the slope in feet per feet. Second line, that one is the hydraulic radius line. And this one is the turning line. Fourth one is the velocity in feet per second. Fifth one is the roughness coefficient. And some values we have in the data. R is the 0.6, that is the hydraulic radius. And slope is the 0.003. And friction coefficient is the 0.02. In very first step, we will identify our point in the slope. And we will trace the second n coefficient on the n line, and we will meet these two points by a straight line. In second step, we have the value of r, hydraulic radius is 0.6. trace that point on this line, and starting from that point, passing through the intersection of the turning line and the line between slope and the n, we will pass the line starting from R through that intersection, and we will touch the line at the velocity line, and we will find the number is 2.9. that is the velocity of the value of the velocity. Next, berm. Bank of the channel is called the berm. See, this is the cross sectional, and this one is the, and second one right and left, these are the berms. Head loss, decrease in the full supply level due to the slope. By this figure, you can watch and understand easily. This is a distance x. Due to the slope, there is a difference in elevation. At that point, water will flow under gravity, this point to that point, and there will be cause a depression in the volume of the supply level. That is the head loss due to slope. Difference in elevation per unit length, drop per unit length is called the slope. It is the slope. This, now we will discuss the side slope. It is the slope of inclined surface of trapezoidal channel and is expressed as ratio of horizontal to vertical. Flow depth and the freeboard. See, this colored cross sectional area is the area of the cross sectional flow from the water is flowing, and in the water channel cross section, this one is the freeboard. That is to safeguard the some contingencies are in the rainy season or high flood time, there is some area we leave for the safety to avoid the overtopping of the water from the cross water channel. It is called the freeboard, and it is decided from the 70 mm to 100 mm, and beyond these range we don't select this safety factor of the water channel. Full supply level, that is the level which is designed for any water channel, that be minor, canal or the water course, that is called the full supply level. Siphon is a structure that carries the discharge of one channel beneath the bed of an other channel. Drop, structure used to drop water at lower level and dissipate the excessive energy, is called the drop. The final sheet of this video, right of way. The space fixed by the government for a community water course along its sanctioned route is called the right of way. Check structures. Structures that heads up the FSL up to the elevation needed for the turnout, that is called the check structure. Turnout control structure that diverts water from water course to the field. So our today video is ended. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell button for the upcoming videos, notifications of upcoming videos. Your subscription and watch time on this channel is a token of encouragement for us. Please keep on watching this channel. Thanks a lot.